ఇట్ ఫీల్స్ లైక్ అన్ ఇంట్రాగేషన్ ఇంకా ఇన్ ద డాన్ బిగ్ డాన్ హియర్ సెకండ్ రో ఆల్ లుక్ లైక్ సిబిఐ ఆఫీసర్స్ ఐటీ డిపార్ట్మెంట్ ఎవ్రీవన్ వేరింగ్ గ్లాసెస్ అండ్ లైక్ nicely in formals. I feel like I'm getting raided and interrogated at the same time, but Thirumba, I'm going to try. It's been a while since Nota, but Thirumba unga ellarium meet panradhu romba santoshama or bhayama or tension a irukku. No Thirukkural this time. This time only dancing. Only dancing and singing today. Thirukkural. I will give you political pudiyavanana ennai aasayoda anaitukonda enadu ir Tamil makkale vanakkam. Got you. So yes, we are here today. I'm here again after a while in Chennai. Really happy and proud to be releasing my next film, Dear Comrade, in all the major South Indian languages. And I'm very happy to be, after Nota, everyone was asking, when will you do a Tamil film again? When will you do Tamil film again? While we were shooting Dear Comrade, I felt like this is a film that people across regions and languages will love to watch. And I felt it's a story that our team had the responsibility of taking beyond Telugu. Because this film is not just entertainment, this film is an emotion, and this film is, this, every boy is not Bobby. I play a character called Bobby, but we will all know a boy like Bobby in our life, but I think every girl is Lily. Every girl has the ambitions of Lily. Every girl faces issues that Lily has faced in her life, and every girl's looking to overcome them, and every girl falls in love like Lily. And hopefully if you have like a Bobby in life, if you have a comrade like him in life, it's nice. So I feel this was a story we wanted every father, brother, son, daughter, girl, everyone to see anyways. So we decided to bring it to all languages, and I'm really happy here. Really happy to be here. And for anyone asking if I dubbed in Tamil, I'll tell you I didn't dub. What is for sorry? Manichittirukinga. Manichidinga. Due to an absolute lack of time, and I couldn't dub it in Tamil, but I think it's really well done. I dubbed only in Telugu, which also took me forever. I just finished dubbing 2 days back. That's about the film, and we are coming out July 26th na ennoda padam. This is all Nota template. This is what I said. July 26th na ennoda padam, Dear Comrade, theater la release agapogadu. Theater la sandhiklam. Theater la sandhiklam. And so today, this evening, we came, the primary reason for coming was to celebrate the music of Dear Comrade. I think it is my best album in my career so far. And Comrade, lots of you will ask, is it a political film? Comrade essentially meant a companion, a friend, someone who fought with you in your cause. Originally, it was used in the army. Someone who was fighting beside you is like a brother, a comrade. So in this film, that is the essence. It's not a political film, but it's about supporting. It's about having that person in your life who supports you. So we decided to come celebrate this with all our comrades across the four regions. Instead of just coming and speaking, we thought, these people turn up to theaters. I didn't do a Tamil film before Nota. I didn't attempt to dub any film. But they still watched my Telugu films, still sent me so much love. I every day receive one parcel from Chennai, Sri Lanka, Malaysia, Singapore. People send letters and parcels. And I decided why don't we come down to at least the places, the cities we can, and have fun and celebrate? And this girl is like, kids. So we decided to come and do this, and today evening at Chennai Trade Center we'll be doing one celebration, and whoever comes, I hope you get comfortably seated, and you will have fun. I'll take any questions that you have. Oh yeah, we are supposed, every time I announce we'll release at 11:11 and we are never ready. Apologies to everyone who's been waiting. Comrade Anthem is a really special song to us because two friends, they're not even friends. Dulkar is a friend, but Makkal Selvan, Vijay Sethupathi Anna, I don't even know him. I've never met him. I've been very fascinated by the man, by his process, and I've watched his interviews. One call, and they came together and sang this song. Why this song is so important is it is the entire philosophy of the film. It is a philosophy that I believed in life. It talks about fighting for what we love, and each of us is fighting on an everyday basis for survival, for money, for respect in our professions, for respect in our families. So I think it's so we're every one of us are fighting for what we love, and this, I think this song is very important. This is the song that, you know, on a low day when I hear it, it's been a favorite of mine. In the gym when I'm not able to do enough reps, I put this music and I crank two more reps, and it's a very motivating song, and it was really important to have. And it shows the camaraderie. It shows when two stars from their respective industries come and do this. I feel absolute love and gratitude towards Vijay Sethupathi and Dulkar for doing this, and you're going to love this song. It'll be out sometime today. They're working on it. Whenever it's out, I'm sure it's fire, man. That song's like fire. You're asking why didn't Nota work? Enough. I didn't get a script that excited me enough. Because Tamil lag pananum romba romba effort I have to put. It's what effort I put in Telugu, which is already by the end of the film I'm almost dead. In Tamil I have to put like literally into 100. Telugu, you give me one page dialogue, it takes me 2 minutes. Tamil, you give me one page dialogue, it takes me 3 days. It takes me 3 days because on set, I can't think of word. I can't be like, and I don't like to even make pronunciation mistake. I learnt my dialogue, this Pudhiyavanana Ennai Aasayodana Itkonda is from Nota. I learnt it so much then that suddenly when you ask me for Thirukural, I can say it. Those many hours I spent on each dialogue, because on set I don't want to think. If I'm talking, I need to talk like a Tamil paya. I need to talk like a boy born here, brought up here. So it takes so much effort. So I need one script that is super duper exciting for me to put myself through that sort of. In 3 months of doing Nota, I became like Dhoni. I got like some 35 white gray hair from the stress I go through. So I grow older quicker. That much effort it takes. But one thing I do is any films that I really think that audience across will enjoy, I'm going to get them dubbed. I'm looking to collaborate, and when I find a really nice script, you will see me back here because I want to, I guess. I want to do. Okay, Naraya audience, huh? I will, in July 26th, I'll decide if Naraya audience is there or not. all of you keep saying Naraya audience, Naraya fans, July 26th, if I see tickets sold, then I will believe you.
Most of the students or students education comes only in Telugu industry. Does it mean that the governments till date have not fulfilled the requirements of the public?
Most
of the student education films have come in Telugu.
Okay.
Does it mean that the government so far ruled in Andhra Pradesh, both Telangana and Andhra Pradesh, have not fulfilled the requirements of the public?
Actually, number one, my film's not based on student education. I play
agitation.
Okay. So the agitation in this film is not against education. You know, every college, be it Tamil Nadu, Kerala. Tell me like one, two films of on student agitation, because I am not aware. Oh, that is ancient. I will.
நீங்க சொல்றது கரெக்ட். இது வந்து இந்த படம் தமிழ்ல வருது ஓகேங்களா. தமிழ்நாட்டு படத்தை பத்தி பண்ணும்போது இது ஆந்திராவோட பிரச்சனை நமக்கு வேண்டாம். இல்ல இது வந்து தமிழ்நாடு ப்ரோகிரஸ்னால ஆந்திரா கவர்மெண்ட் பத்தியும் ஆந்திரா பொலிட்டிக்ஸும் இங்க நம்ம பேச வேணாம். We can avoid that.
I think the governments are doing, I'm sure there is a gap across states in public education, but governments are constantly working. Right now back home we have a really good government in place. They've won the second election and they won with overwhelming majority, which means the people are happy comparatively with the progress they're doing. And we hope, the thing is, generally across India, I don't know for since what, there are 100 reasons, but administration, there's a lot of scope to improve, and lot, and also our population, but it has to do with people as well. But they're doing well, and we just hope that it keeps improving the quality of education everywhere. See, it is about the objective of what you're fighting. Initially, like I said, comrade, the word came from the army. It was someone who was fighting along with you for the same cause. Later, communist parties took that word. And when communist parties started, they were fighting against inequality because there was a huge gap between. So they were fighting against that, and there was the word comrade. So, and generally everyone, everything, it depends. In this film, comrade is about a friend in your life. So I don't know about other comrades. I haven't researched them, met them, because this guy is a boy. He's just a regular boy in college who's fighting for what he believes in. And anything in life, anyone in life, not everyone will like them. If you're on their side, you like them. If you're on the other side, you don't like them. So that's how life is in general. No one will like anyone. Everyone doesn't like me. Whoever likes me, they like me. There will be people who don't, and we cannot expect everyone to agree with you and like you. And that's how the world is. Before Telugu heroes used to be soft.
Telugu heroes are really looking soft like you. So what is the,
and
is
before it, Tamil heroes used to be soft, now they are so what am I supposed to answer to that?
So time changes is happening.
But after growing beard also I'm looking soft. Still there, still very soft.
Last month they met Yash. So now you are.
With the beard also you look soft.
Smart.
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 ஓகே. We should launch you in Tamil. Like, or a mass padam la launch pananum. I'm sure, I don't know. Like, this is one of the hardest questions. I have no answer to this. இது பொலிட்டிக்கல் ஸ்டோரி இல்லை, இது ஒரு ஸ்ட்ரெயிட் ஃபார்வர்ட் ஒரு லவ் ஸ்டோரி அண்ட் ஹவு தே ரியாக்ட் டு இன்சிடென்ட்ஸ் இன் ஆல் ஆர் லைஃப்ஸ். வி ஃபேஸ் சம் இஷ்யூஸ், ஹவு வி கம் ஓவர் இட், ஹவு வி ஃபேஸ் இட் இஸ் த ஸ்டோரி. தி ஸ்டோரி டாக்ஸ் அபவுட் ஃபைட் ஃபார் வாட் யூ லவ். ப்ரதி இண்டிவிஜுவல், எவ்ரி இண்டிவிஜுவல் ஜெர்னி, ஒக இண்டிவிஜுவல் ஜெர்னி இந்த படம். ஸோ நோ, நத்திங் பொலிட்டிக்கல் இந்த ஃபிலிம். பட் தட்ஸ் வை ஐம் சேயிங் த மீனிங் ஆஃப் த வேர்ட் காமரேட் இஸ் நாட் தட் ஐ ஆம் சப்போர்ட்டிங் அ பொலிட்டிக்கல் பார்ட்டி. இட் மீன்ஸ் த ஆக்சுவல் மீனிங், விச் மீன்ஸ் கேமராட்ரி ஆர் கம்பேனியன். The thing is, if this question also has been asked repeatedly to me, but it's actually very untrue, because I don't blame the fact that I'm being asked this question, because my previous film of where I played an angry young man has left such an impact that you don't remember most things I did after. But the three films I did after, I didn't play an angry young man. In Geeta Govindam, I played a very, very scared, soft man. In Taxi Wala, I played a very scared, innocent taxi driver. So this is coming after a gap of three films, and it's about time I came back to the angry young man mode. But I guess the images of the angry young man have it's left such an image that you keep thinking this is the next film, that all I've been doing is that, but that's untrue. So yeah. Yeah, but yeah, you like the angry young man, that's nice, but it's not why I'm even giving this explanation, because people are asking me, do you enjoy doing this, every film you are doing this? I'm like, but I'm not, so I'm not doing this. Yeah. I already find so much clutter on a poster. So, yeah, they do think, but I assume that eventually with the trailer, with the teaser, with the songs, that you get into the vibe of the movie more, and I don't mind doing a bit of explanation. And when you see the film, you'll understand what it's about and how it means so much more. Okay. இப்போ நவ் ஆல் த இன்டர்வியூஸ் தட் யூ புட், இன்ஸ்டெட் ஆஃப் சேயிங் விஜய் தேவர்கொண்டா ரஷ்மிகா கெமிஸ்ட்ரி ஒன் மோர் லிப் லாக், இன்ஸ்டெட் ஆஃப் புட்டிங் திஸ் ஹெட்லைன்ஸ் புட் இது இது காதல் படம், கம்யூனிஸ்ட் சினிமா படம் இல்லை. Now you put that title, you will also help me instead of this. So all of you do that and clarity will come, for everyone will get clarity. What to do? Helpless, all of us is going on. Huh? Sorry? Till you get the shot right, I guess you never generally it's as in now we are all having fun and we are laughing about it, but for us cinema is very serious. For me, when I do a film, it's a very serious thing. It's storytelling, and it is my career. It is my producer's huge money, my debutant director, his entire life is dependent on this. There are 40 new actors who've struggled to get a break and are now playing smaller roles. It's this girl's career, and the amount of hate an actress gets simply just because we can take their case and we can feel better about ourselves. The amount of people that abuse her and judge her for doing this, we don't want to do this. But then when it comes to the film, we feel like the film is bigger than all of this. It's okay. 1 week, 1-2 months before a film release, some people will abuse, some people understand, we'll take it. When the film releases, they will understand the bigger story we are trying to tell, which is very important with Dear Comrade. And it's I feel it'll leave a lasting impact on people. For the sake of that and for the sake of bringing these characters into life, we do what we have to. So it's not as light as people would like to make it be. It's not fun and games. It's a very serious job that we do, and we take it extremely seriously. From the film, I don't know, each one will take their own bits, I guess. Do I want them to take something? Do I don't want them? As in, it's a story I feel needs to be told, and it will leave an impact that it has to. They don't have to take anything. The film will give them what it has to. If they come and watch, it'll affect them. And then I'm saying it in the film. I think when I say it as a message, no, it sounds too boring and sounds too blah. So when you tell about a story that happened, it makes more sense. They will get it when they watch the film. Yeah. Not the essence of communism, but the essence of fighting for your rights is there. So in that, same thing, huh? So now if communism is fighting for your rights, I think we are all communists. Won't we fight for our rights? We will. So the spirit of not, you know, all of us, when we get, when we don't get what we deserve, we are like, okay, let's go on. You paid for something, you don't get it. We voted a party into power, but they don't do what is required. We adjust. And our middle class has the biggest level of patience. We are patient with everything. We are like, why speak? We are brought up in fear, and we're brought up in like, just let's mind our business. It's okay. Even current is not there in our house. We don't call board and say, "Arey, why is not?" We see next house. Oh, he also doesn't have current. It's okay. All of us don't have. We'll wait. But so I think the strength, the philosophy of fighting, which communists took over, is fighting for equal rights, be it lands, be it voting power, be it lots of things. That philosophy came. That spirit and that philosophy came, but no other political. Now everything has taken one direction. So we don't subscribe to any political party's direction. We only subscribe to the spirit of, and that is the only propaganda we are doing, is everyone needs to fight. Fight for what you love. That is the only message we'd like to give. Yes, brother.
Now it's like women empowerment and all that.
Yeah.
So why do all the movies come with just the actor's name in the front? The hero's name.
Yeah.
Vijay Deverakonda. She's not the actor, right? Don't see
her. True, true, true.
Like, first question.
So.
I mean, all. It's not this, like, all the movies.
I know it does. We. In this, like, I can't speak for other films, but in this film, Lily is very, very important. Lily is very important to the film. So, Abba, asal excited, huh? So, Lily is very important to this film, and she absolutely deserves her Vijay Devarakonda and Rashmika Mandanna in. So, what we did is, out of our interest, we made some posters for her, but she's not a Rashmika Mandanna poster for her. Rashmika Mandanna in Dear Comrade, we made a bunch of posters. But I guess having this is a business call. Having the lead actor's name, I think this particular thing is a business call for sale in areas beyond Hyderabad or Chennai. So when you go elsewhere, I think they want to see that, okay, this guy is here, and you want them to pull him in. And she's a star, and she's got a huge fan following. She's got a huge fan following. I'm going to make now. Now I'll make. We'll try. We'll figure something. We'll do something. Yes. Oh no. Anantapurlo, which is near, it's like 4 hours from Bangalore, but it's actually in Andhra Pradesh.
Now, because you grew up like in a hostel and all
that, yeah.
Your accent and your language and all, it could have been affected in some way or the
other. Yes.
So how come now you speak Pakka Telangana Telugu and you speak with other accent and all that? Do you have to do that specifically to attract your audience, or is it because it's, that's how it is?
Did you know that
I
have absolute no need to, and it's only natural I speak the language that is spoken at home, that's spoken by my friends. When I came out of 10th standard, I spoke zero Telugu, because in my hostel we spoke only English. So then post 10th, in my intermediate, the language I speak is what I absorbed from my college, from my home, from my relatives. So this is the language that was spoken in Hyderabad. And you should know specifically that Telangana was a dialect that was completely looked down upon being spoken in mainstream cinema. When I did my first film, I was asked not to speak this dialect. But I was like, dude, this is how I speak, and this is my language, and this is how I will speak. I was even advised not to speak it in interviews. Because generally, cinema followed a neutral language back home. Everyone preferred a neutral language so that everyone understood it. Hyderabad is a very multicultural city. It has lots of people from all states. It has Telangana people, Andhra people, all kinds of dialect. And Hyderabad, actually, the dialect is very mixed. If you go into rural Telangana, it's very different from what I speak. So the neutral language, which is kind of the neutral dialect, neutral slang, which is kind of spoken in the Vijayawada region, was what's preferred, because it's that side they again have a very strong dialect. So overall, they would speak this dialect, and it was most acceptable because people across the state could understand it. But I guess I decided to do this, and now because it worked, the question of do you make an attempt to speak this, but you wake me up in the middle of the night, this is what will come out.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, you're Telugu?
Oh,
okay. Lovely, say hi to auntie.
Sir, you have to tell me a super duper hit, Arjun Reddy, India remake,
He's asking if I, why didn't I do it in all languages?
No, no, see, Arjun Reddy has been remake twice. Yeah. They haven't released. So why did you thought of, I said you come here and releasing this film in all languages?
Because Arjun Reddy didn't release. No, no, it will release. Now it's ready. Yesterday only I met Vikram sir on the plane. And I wish all the best to Dhruv. I hope it does really well. The Hindi version did super well. And I hope it does equally well for Dhruv. It's his first film, and I wish him well.